We're so happy that you're able to come here tonight. And did you all enjoy the audio appetizer that you had? The mental aperitif. I'm not a poet, so I'm going to stop there. But tonight we are really, really thrilled to be helping Marie Yuen as our Arts Initiative performer. And of course, special thanks to NRE Communications. The original concept idea was from Irene Qualifin. So thank you very much. As I mentioned, we're Asian Improv Arts Midwest. You should have the pamphlet here to see who we are, what we do. Take a look when you have a chance. And without further ado, we're going to present Poesy with the speaker, Ed Lott.
Infinity by Marie Yuen. Beneath that cold, austere heart lies a dream unknowingly spoken, of thunder and lightning mixed together in a cacophony of sound, and a single icicle. Drip, 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 dripping off the roof of a neighboring gutter. Therein lies simplicity itself and the possibilities yet to be discovered. Ship by Marie Yuen. I spy the phantom ship today, 5 miles above the sea. And ere my snow-white ship sailed on, this vision came to me. Shore that kissed the clouds, that hid the moon from heaven's darkened door. Thank you. as fireflies flickered on in search of chemistry. Twilight into place, whilst curlicues of clouds swirl by, a scattershot of lace. Chased the sun away, so vast all of the clouds gave way, and told a storm was nigh. Sky and fell athwart my phantom ship as it kept sailing by. The race was on, twixt my ship, the storm, and I. Thank you. shades of sky, until a squall of sudden strength reminded me that I... Quite hard, I heeded not the rain until I tripped upon a stone all by myself there all alone. I'd been so eager to be home, my legs gave out, and with a shout, I fell down from the pain. Search to find some card of where I might have dined, but finding none was in a bind to know my heart's desire. Changed her course, conspired to try to find and rescue me. times I saw the sainted ground. 5 miles beneath, she said I drowned when I fell and hit my head. Too late it was when she came by. She couldn't lose. She had to try. And so she found that I could fly. At least that's what she said. Burst forth and put to flight the phantoms of the sky. Still, her siren song of love until myself I freed by force of will, and with a sudden cry, cast myself into the sky. Icy blast, bereft, she wept with pain, then sulked long, a kasimbo on the mead's desert plain. I stopped my ears. She doubled back, distraught, perplexed, blind, because I would not follow her and leave all else behind. She could not give me up, she said, for we were meant to be. And if I must not follow her, then she would follow me. Tempting me with such delights the world has ever known, she promised me that I would see her grand celestial home. Home of glass and wood and stone? I asked this would-be bride. She shook her head and sighed. Alas, that's when I knew she lied. Trice, yes, quite star-crossed, this maid of ice and mist and frost had gambled for me, but she lost. Not so, my ring of gold embossed, that she had almost nearly tossed. Belatedly, I learned the cost of her stately pleasure dome, and my amble far from home. She sought to coax me. The moon did wax and wane before Mount Machu Picchu were a swift torrential rain. Such devastation, my heart took sick instead at the vast untold destruction, and the search for those not dead. Sailor's nymph was she, but Tethys with a hook. So I prefer to be the king and not the rook. I saw it, and so I escaped her wrath, when suddenly a jet stream slithered across our past. A phantom ship of kneeling lads, which was how I got away at last, not double time, but triple fast. Jamaican dogwoods bloomed, and and the silvery fishes zoomed. Found the rock that laid me low, down the path where I did go. When I blacked out from the pain in the dogwood-scented rain, then there appeared a flash of light. As I came to, I saw my wife. She'd searched the marshes in her fright when I did not return. Of all my joy and strife. The apple of my eye.